Coffee today is more than just a drink, it's a pastime. Roughly 6.7 million tons of coffee are produced annually. Coffee has, for years, served as an anti-sleep aid for college students across America. Its two leading species are the Coffea arabica and the Robusta. Robusta being a cheaper, less flavorful sort, though containing nearly 40% more caffeine. Coffee today is commonly separated in regard to its origin, Ethiopian, Brazilian, Italian, etc. As different regions contain different minerals within their land, each coffee develops its distinctive characteristics such as flavor, aroma, body, acidity, and mouthfeel. Coffee has, for years, served as a focusing aid for college students across America. California, San Diego, coffee is as common as water in the dining halls. Whether you're waiting for class outside Warren Lecture Hall or Earl's Place, Plaza Cafe, or Ocean View Terrace, a cup of coffee is a necessity to many students, valued like gold. Coffee is a bean that grows primarily in Brazil, the largest coffee exporting nation to date. It originated in Ethiopia, growing as a seed to the coffee plant, commonly misconstrued as a coffee bean. Starbucks coffee, a recent national fad of the last decade, has perfected the process of getting quality products to the people. But what actually goes into a grande coffee at the corner of Starbucks?
All right, when and how did you start drinking coffee? I didn't start drinking coffee until I was probably about 18 and in college.
Is it for studying purposes?
And just fun.
Have fun staying up late? Alright. How many cups of coffee do you drink on average?
A day. I drink probably about a half a pot of coffee, or if I come to Starbucks, I'll have Starbucks. But usually in the morning, it's half a pot of coffee.
So you say you drink that every day?
Yes.
Would you consider coffee an addiction?
Probably. Yes.
What do you think about coffee that makes it so addictive?
I just think that the whole social thing around it, as far as, you know, Starbucks and how big it's become, and just the pursuit of really, you know, well-made coffees, you know, and how many choices you have in coffee these days. And it's like, I don't know, ever since Starbucks has been around, it's, you know, grown. A small thing that's been around forever.
So you'd say it's more bigger than caffeine. What would you do without coffee?
Without coffee? Probably drink tea.
Oh,
just something to something.
How did you begin drinking coffee?
Well, I made that fatal mistake many years ago when I was in college, and needed to stay awake, so I started
doing caffeine.
How many cups of coffee do you drink?
In a day? Probably just one of these, one Americano a day, and not even every day.
What is it about coffee that makes it so addictive?
That's the caffeine.
What would you do without your coffee?
I'd just live a normal, real life. And I wouldn't have to go to, like, 12-step programs on stopping addictions. Because this is an addiction for me.
And Brickton will have...
How did you begin drinking coffee?
How old was that beginning?
Well, when and how? Like, were you in college? Did you study?
I believe I was. I started in junior college, actually.
Oh, wow.
I never drank in high school. I never drank after that. It was just in junior college. But, you know, midterms, of course, and finals came, and it's like, you know, I need to stay up, not just to cramp, but just to maintain your grade point average. You need something to get by. Coffee's a pretty natural thing. Natural thing to drink.
So, how many cups of coffee do you drink on average daily?
On an average daily? Probably just one.
Just one?
Yeah.
Do you drink one, would you say you drink one every day of the week, or just...
I would say one to three every week. Depends on, I start to exercise, then I definitely will have like two just to get me up. It'd be really early in the morning. So I want to be jazzed by our workout.
Got it. Would you consider yourself addicted to coffee?
No. Because there's other alternatives out there in case. I don't know, I think an alternative would be tea.
Do you like coffee when you first started out?
I thought it was okay. You know, I'd always see my friends and family members always drinking coffee.
So more of a acquired taste.
I think so, yeah. After the first, second, third, after that, it's more of a acquired taste. Exactly.
When would you say coffee became more than just a drink?
Probably when it became invented into Starbucks. When Starbucks and Coffee Bean and stores like that started popping up, the merchandise too, it became part of our culture. We started seeing it in television shows, we started seeing it in movies, and then movies would spoof on. You see Austin Powers, the gold member. He'd go back in time. And Austin Powers, they showed that too, how they went back in time and how Starbucks is now. They're the owners of Starbucks. So actually, Starbucks probably was the beginning of it all.
An American institution and timely pastime.